Welcome everyone to St. Paul Evangelical Lutheran Church as we celebrate our first Sunday of Advent. I hope everybody has had a nice and restful Thanksgiving. We'll begin with our order of confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthfully magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead to sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. The Almighty God strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen.
Blessed are you, O Lord, our God, ruler of the universe. You call all nations to walk in your light and to seek your ways of justice and peace. For the night is past, and the dawn of your coming is near. Bless us as we light the first candle of this wreath. Rouse us from sleep, that we may be ready to greet our Lord when he comes and welcome him into our hearts and homes. For he is our light and our salvation. Blessed be God forever.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Until the coming of your new day. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The first reading this morning comes from the book of Isaiah, the 64th chapter. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence, as when fire kindles brushwood and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down, the mountains quaked at your presence. From ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God besides you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways. But you were wandering, and we sinned. Because you hid yourself, we transgressed. We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy cloth. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you. For you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay and you are our potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity forever. Now consider, we are all your people. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We will read Psalm 80 responsibly. Hear, O shepherd of Israel, leading Joseph like a flock, shine forth, you that are enthroned upon the cherubim.
In the presence of Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh, stir up your strength and come to help us.
Restore us, O God. Let your face shine upon us, and we shall be saved.
O Lord of hosts, you long with your anger to fume when your people pray.
You have fed them with the bread of tears. You have given them bowls of tears to drink.
You have made us the derision of our neighbors, and our enemies laugh us to scorn.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Let your face shine upon us, and we shall be saved.
Let your hand be upon the one at your right hand, the one you have made so strong for yourself.
And so will we never turn away from you. Give us life that we may call upon your name.
Restore us, O Lord, God of hosts. Let your face shine upon us, and we shall be saved.
The second reading this morning comes from 1 Corinthians. Grace to you and peace from God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him, you are called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
After the suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be failing from heaven, and the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as it branches, becomes tender, and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near at the very gates. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware and keep you alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his slave in charge, each with his word, and commands the doorkeeper to be on the watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening or at midnight or at cock crow or at dawn. or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We all fade like a leaf. It's going to be a different holiday season. We know that. First time we realize that it's definitely a different holiday season is when you drive for big retail stores and there is no lines outside at Black Friday. Something is different. Something has changed. For most of us, on the surface, those are changes for the worse. Those are not good changes. Not able to gather with everybody that we used to on Thanksgiving. Perhaps the same on Christmas. That event of dividing ourselves with our families after get together and each one go to a line on the store. That adventure that begins in the early hours in the morning to get the best deals, not there. The craziness of the Advent season will also not be there. All that hurry up to find the gifts and Christmas parties. And, oh my gosh, I love Christmas presents. This is not going to have anyone this year. What are you going to do? It's a funny thing. That in previous years, always during the season of Advent, I thought that the mood of our service, the songs, the reading, never match the frenzy of the holiday season. We are always too stressed out, too busy, trying to go to every party, attending every event, and buying every gift. Or we just want to be joyful because we love the holiday season. And the liturgy just doesn't match Advent, the season of wait in the absence of light. So it will be different this year. In many ways, not so good. We'll miss things, we'll long for things. But perhaps the royal priesthood of all believers, community of saints, will have the chance to abide by the things that matter, or by the one that matters. See, it's very easy to leave aside and lose the sight of what we are preparing and why we are celebrating this season. In times of abundance, when everything is happening, is about everything. Except in Christmas Eve, kind of light service. It's everything but the coming of our Savior. So we have this opportunity this year, perhaps, to experience the oldest tradition of the church. I can tell you it's not the same tradition if you are the Southern Hemisphere. It's summer and everybody's at the beach now. If you can find a place remote and go away from COVID-19. But for us in the Northern Hemisphere, the same way that the first believers experience, is the time when life dims. The leaves have fallen, the fields are done and bare. All is left for us without the stresses and the anxieties and the frenzy, it's wait. We don't live in a culture when we like to wait. We live in a culture where most of us, extroverts, I'm not one of them, but you are, don't like to stay quiet and wait for promises. You are go-getters. You want to mingle with people. This season, perhaps, we have no choice. We have no choice for the sake of our neighbor. We have no choice for the sake of ourselves. If we would like to celebrate many holidays to come. So what is left for us is this holy expectation. It's the reminder that there are beginnings and there are ends as we go through life. See, Jesus was never meant to be for us one beginning and one end. Remember, there is a season for everything. There is a season together and to celebrate when life is abundant. There is a season when things are not happening like we wish. And we have nothing left. But wait. To be patient. Vigilant, yes, on the practice of our faith in way, presence of mind, praise, trust, striving for good things, resisting despair and anger and division. See, there is a season when we all faint. There are seasons where in our trespasses, as Isaiah says, take over us. When we feel like God has his face hidden from us. When we feel broken beyond repair. It is my invitation that in this season, we feel inspired to remember as we prepare the way of the only one who can save us. that we are nothing but clay. And there is only one who can fix what is broken. Comes when things are ready. He comes when the time is right. He will come again and again and again. And the season to celebrate and the reasons to be joyful will come with him. Together, I invite you to profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. God of power and might, dear, open the heavens and come quickly to this weary world. Hear our prayers for everyone in need. We pray for the ministry we share in Christ's name. Open our hearts to a call for justice, peace, and healing. Attune us to the need of the world as you draw near. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for this planet in need of restoration, for devastated habitats, polluted waters, thawing ice, blazing fires, swelling floods, and long-lasting drought. Renew the face of the earth and our relationship to it. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for all people who care for others in our community and around the world. Fill them with compassion and the power of respond with justice for those who are oppressed, with welcome for those who are excluded, and with relief for those who suffer. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for people who are in crisis as the seasons change. For those without homes face severe weather. For those who are unemployed or underemployed. For those in poverty facing food insecurity. For those sick with COVID-19. For those recovering from their illnesses. Relieve their burdens, sustain their bodies, and ease their minds. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for the people in our families and congregations who live with depression, anxiety, chronic pain, addiction, and other invisible illnesses. Ease their suffering and support them when they struggle. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Beloved of God, you now may offer your own intercessions. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We give thanks for the lives and witness of those who died while waiting for justice, peace, or healing. Those whose name we know and those whose names are known only to you. Sustain all who still yearn for the completion of your redeeming work. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Draw near to us, O God, and receive our prayers for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. You comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, from whom you will also make all things new in the day when he comes to judge the world in righteousness. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy God, the beginning and the end, our salvation and our hope, we praise you for creating a world of order and beauty. When we brought on chaos, cruelty, and despair, you sent the prophets to proclaim your justice and mercy. At this end of the ages, your Son Jesus came to bring us your love and to heal all the suffering world. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks, and gave for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life, death, and resurrection, we await his coming again in righteousness and peace. Send your Spirit on us and on this bread and wine we share here or at our homes. Strengthen our faith, increase our hope, and bring to birth the justice and joy of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Gathering to one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Even as we watch and wait, Christ is here. Come, eat, and drink.
Mercy on us, thou
things that the Lord Christ shed for you. This is the body of Christ given for you.
This is the body of Christ shed for you.
The bread and the cup of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Gracious and abundant God, you have done great things for us, and we rejoice. In this bread and cup, you give us life forever. In your boundless mercy, strengthen us and open our hearts to the world's needs. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The Creator of the stars bless you this Advent in waiting. The long-expected Savior filled with love. The unexpected Spirit guide your journey now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
Just